I think I did an interview for them in New York.
Welcome back. Having a baby, getting an agent. Are you chatting?
Sorry, we're just having the chat. Carry on.
Having a bit of a chatter. Having a baby, getting engaged, embracing wellness, and hosting the Irish Post Music Awards. For one woman, the past year has brought great change.
It's our favourite Gwen Gore, Sheila Shaw, you ladies and gentlemen. Good morning. How are you?
Good morning.
Lovely to have you with us.
Isn't this lovely, guys?
Isn't it nice? This looks like, doesn't it look like the Amalfi Coast?
Doesn't it just? Looking around, look at the views here, Ballymount.
Yeah, exactly. The last when was the last time that Sheila was in with us? Can you remember?
I can't remember.
You weren't pregnant anyway.
No, so and I was. You were with me. We were chanting. We were getting our chant on in a yoga studio.
Yes,
so that was definitely preconception.
Yeah.
So since then, I've been busy. Yeah, he's brilliant.
Tell us, how old is he now?
10 months now, and
he's baby Cahill.
Baby Cahill. He's the crack. You know,
the great entertainment.
Yeah, it's full of the chats and full of pulling and dragging and just mad for life.
Yeah.
You know, he's like, let me at it. I want to just go here. You know, what
full
can I explore?
Wonder where he gets
full of action. I know, I know. as people say, he didn't lick it off a stone.
But we were chatting beforehand, and you were talking about the fact that you continued with yoga and meditation and mindfulness throughout your pregnancy as well, and your chanting. Do you find, did you find rather that had a positive impact on, you know, on the whole birth and the aftermath?
Definitely, definitely, Laura. I suppose for me, I had this dream of wanting the Earth mother, natural birth, and then people saying, we'll see what you're like when it comes down to it. But actually, luckily, I got the dream. You know, people say don't get too hung up on your birth
story
preferences. But I just had I was letting go and letting things happen. But I managed to have a natural birth, what I wanted. I was really, really lucky. Obviously, I had no control over that. Baby decided.
Yes, of course.
And I was lucky. Yeah. But I did. And
it can be an overwhelming time afterwards. I'm sure Simon knows well, because Lisa's obviously had 4 babies. Mm. And it can be a very surreal time, especially for women, all the hormones leaving the body.
Absolutely. And that's the thing, and I've spoken about this in the past. I may have had the dream birth experience, but I had a tough old time afterwards. Breastfeeding was really hard for me.
Did you find it tough?
I assumed that because I had this perfect, you know, here he comes, no interventions,
everything
no drugs, everything else was granted. And it wasn't.
No.
So look, it's not a one size fits all. And we just got to have, you know, we got to have, take baby steps, I think. Motherhood, parenthood, it's a huge change.
Baby steps, see what you did there, baby
steps. See.
And you know what, you know, there's no right or wrong way to do it. You can only do your best. That's what I keep chanting to myself anyway.
Yeah. And like, I think we're just, I don't know about you guys, but I feel like you're just chanting your arm every day. And you're doing it with, you know, you're doing it with as much love and care and all the rest. But you are kind of just going with the flow and, like, really.
And who knows?
Who knows?
Yeah, on top of that, Sheila, of course, you know, the baby is taking up majority of time, as we're all aware of.
Yes.
Talk to us about the Irish Post Music Awards. Now, I was asking you, we were saying the Irish Post, as in the newspaper.
Yes.
The diaspora newspaper.
Absolutely.
It's a paper I'm familiar with, having spent time in the States. Is that it?
That's the one, exactly, Simon. That's the one.
So how long are these running? What happens?
This is a brand new awards. They've had other awards. They've had Country Music Awards. Mm. They had an award ceremony in the UK last year with Eamon Holmes and Aoife Ní Chuaidh from TG Cahad. So this one is in association with TG Cahad. It'll be live in Killarney in the INEC on the Thursday night.
Great
venue.
But you're on hosting duties, but at the same time, you have a magnificent voice. Obviously, you've recorded music in the past. And would country music be sort of the genre that you would have sort of love for?
You're very sweet, Laura. Thank you.
You've heard her sing. She's amazing.
I do love to sing. I do love to sing.
Oh, well, I know that.
But who knows? I mean, I'm going to be co-presenting with a singer himself. He's Malachy Cush from the North, singer-songwriter. You never know. We might have a bit of an Al Sing song that night.
Yeah, I was just going to say, you've got a big setup there, though, I'd say, in the INEC. Is there a band on stage?
So, yeah, it's going to be an amazing setup. So
she's
there are
going
10...
to be singing, I'm telling you.
Oh, yeah, live for one night only. No, later on at the after party, perhaps.
But tell us about the awards, though, Sheila, in terms of categories. Is it all-encompassing?
It is, absolutely. So it's everything from best folk, best country, best pop, best indie. You know, there's a Lifetime Achievement Award, best album, all of that. So we have, like, really diverse acts performing on the night from the likes of The Blizzards, Una Healy, The High Kings,
Excellent.
Phil Coulter,
Excellent.
You know, Ryan McMullen. Yeah, really good. Cleona Hagen, who's a big star now in the country scene. So, yeah, it's a really good mix. Myself and Malachy presenting. It'll be live on TG Cahad.
Yeah.
So it's in association with TG Cahad. So I'll be presenting Askelge and Malachy will be presenting Imirle. So it'll be the combo of the English and Irish, which I think will be lovely.
Huge audience, Sheila, because country music is just getting bigger. Mm. It's phenomenal
absolutely.
Now. When you have the likes of the stars of Nashville, the TV series, selling out the Three Arena.
Totally.
You know, there's some of you.
It's just
but hasn't it always
bigger.
Been big? I mean, Ciara Doherty, who presents has, this show, yeah. she's on a day off.
Yeah.
She is absolutely mad for
fanatical
country music.
It,
yeah. She loves it, yeah.
No, you're right, but it seems, I feel like in the last few years, it just seems to have mushrooms,
yeah.
hasn't it?
Yeah.
Yeah, big yeah. time. So some tickets are still available if people want to get down because it's going to be a great show
yeah,
that
it will
night.
Be, yeah.
So Ticketmaster, £29.50.
I always love when Sheila chats away Askeilge because obviously you're a Gaelic girl, you grew up speaking Irish as your first language, and I'm just interested to see now in 2018 when baby Cathal starts to speak his first words, is he going to be saying whammy or is he going to be well, probably mama or bin, but it could be anything at all. Dada, they always say.
Yeah, yeah.
Look, I can't remember what our fella's
Dada's
first words
the first one,
were.
Isn't it?
Bin was my eldest.
Bin?
Cousin. Yeah.
And who was he referring to?
Well, his name
to?
Was, I think, himself, Ben.
Oh.
Who knows? Were you, are you going to do the bilingual?
Yeah, we are. We're really making an effort.
Yeah.
So my other half, Damien, is from Cork, and he had, I suppose, good Irish growing up at school, but like that, it's like a muscle, I think, if you're not exercising, if you're not using it, mm-hmm. it gets pretty rusty, you know, but he has been very dedicated now since becoming a daddy, and we are really making an effort at home to speak it.
I noticed, Sheila, I was lucky enough to spend some time in the Gaeltacht last year to shoot a movie over there, and we were based in T.G. Cahir's, sort of, you know, their studios, and I'm filmed around the locations, but all the crew, it was a local crew that were on the movie, and they all spoke Irish all day.
Yeah,
oh, really?
Yeah.
And did you find yourself picking it up a bit?
I hadn't a Scooby what they were saying, not a clue. And the gas thing was that the actor's name that was in the movie,
Stephen Dorff. Yeah.
Stephen Dorff played the lead, and he was sort of sitting, was the first one, he said to me, my God, they're all speaking your native tongue. I said, yeah, it's incredible. What are they saying?
Can
I
lie?
Have to make it up. But if it's daily use, as you see, you get rusty, most of us, in Ireland school, and then you don't use it anymore.
I always say for me, it's simple geography. I was lucky. I'm
rare
in the Gaeltacht.
Yeah.
So I spoke it from the early age.
Yeah.
So it's normal, it's natural, it's not weird, it's not a novelty.
You're not even thinking about
so,
it.
So no, and it is. I think it's simply where you were reared, you know. Yeah. I'm really lucky.
And
I'm aware
of
how lucky
it is lovely to have children who grow up in a bilingual household.
Absolutely.
We friends as well, and mum is French, and they're mixing their French and their English, but it's lovely to hear even
absolutely. And I think if they're aware and they're open to hearing new languages, that they're naturally more linguistic, I think, as well, and they'll pick it up more. So hopefully.
I just think A in the Leaving Cert, long term. 18 years down the line, good man Cathal.
I love it.
Yeah,
he would do better than me. Imagine I didn't get an A in my leaving in Irish.
Did you not?
I'm shocked at that.
Gotta be.
Did you turn up?
Oh, no, I did honours, obviously, but like I would have done. This is a language that I should have naturally. I should have been a no-brainer. I got a name.
But the higher level is still tough.
Because you know what it is? For a lot of native speakers, the oral and the oral grant, but the written Irish grammar. Maybe not so great.
Okay.
Yeah.
Because you're not used to writing a down.
There you go. Now I'm telling you everything on
the air.
Yes, confessing all the secrets.
What do you think about the way that Irish
I won't tell you about my other results.
I know we're going completely off topic here, but the way Irish is taught.
Yeah.
Is it getting better?
I think it has a long way to go. I think it's a long way to go. I really think.
And my memory of Irish at school is Peg.
Yeah.
And it makes
I know.
And
luckily, by the time
spine.
We came along, Simon, Peg was
the next generation.
See?
That sent
maybe that might be a stretch now.
Perhaps it was a year later. But, like, no, we were post Peg.
But it's
just
got
about. Yeah, it has got better. I still think it's a long way to go.
Mm.
And I think immersion is the thing. I think it is.
Yeah,
like, when I was speaking to Des Bishop the other night at the IFTAs, and, you know, he spent time in Connemara. And the next thing, he had this amazing Irish. Yeah, he's great Irish.
That's
And it's because he was like you when you were filming. You're surrounded by
you're
hearing
it. Yeah.
You mentioned Damien, the love of your life, a little while ago, and Carl's daddy, and you got engaged there.
We did.
A big congratulations to you. He's a huge support to you, but I just love the fact that he essentially went behind your back, but in the nicest possible way, with your sister.
I know.
To create your beautiful ring and to create this fabulous proposal. And I just think, thinking back to how unwell you were a few years ago and just the polar opposite of how you feel now with your baby and your fiancé. And you've always been a strong advocate for women not wanting or needing a man by their side or a partner by the side. And yet here you are now still obviously saying the same message, if that's
I get you, absolutely. You're dead right.
But a lovely ending to tumultuous couple of years yet, because you had a tough time.
Yeah, I did. And I suppose, look at who in this world hasn't been through challenges, and we're all going to be faced with something at one stage or another. I feel very lucky, actually, because it actually taught me a lot. And it's chilled me out. It's got me appreciating things much more. You know, having come through cancer, I was very, very lucky that I did. And now, in a lovely, lovely phase, I have to say, feel very lucky, you know. Healthy little baby boy. We're happy. We kill each other the odds, huh?
Of course you do.
But we're happy and
that's
we're engaged.
Of a healthy relationship.
Sheila, tell us when the awards are on again, because
the awards are on Thursday night on TG Cahead. They're going out live at 9:30. It'll be myself and Maliki Kush presenting loads of big acts on the night. If you want to head down to the INEC, tickets are still available at Ticketmaster, £29.50.
Well Sheila, pleasure having you
thanks
in and love chatting to you as always.
Great to be on with you guys.
See
thanks
you.
A million guys.
After the break, more summer barbecue party fashion. There's a mouthful. See you soon.
Woohoo!